Kazo District is located in the Kato Corridor, and this explains extended water shortage that continuously affects the district. In most parts of the district, dams are the only source of water, yet they are deemed unhealthy for human consumption.
We have 10 sub-counties, and out of those, there are only 3 towns that really have safe water for drinking. Otherwise, most of our people, they use unsafe water from dams where animals are getting water. So water is not safe for this area.
This prompted the district leaders to host the state minister of water with the hope of developing lasting solutions.
These facilities have been in existence for over four to four years, and they've not been functional. Though there is water down, but there was no mechanism to get water from ground where it was stopped to be pumped to the neighboring communities, especially the towns that are neighboring those water catchment areas. So today, since the minister has come to our district, we expect an improvement. We expect the awakening of some of these projects that the government has heavily invested in money.
Actually, assessment was made. They came and they started drilling the exercise. Water was drilled.
When was
this? It's now 2 years back.
Okay.
Water was drilled. Water yield confirmed that the water yield is enough to supply the neighboring areas. So it was made to this level, and since then the thing has been abandoned. For us as leaders, we have managed to have this thing in place, not tampered with.
The minister visited some of the abandoned water projects in the district. She, however, castigated the district leaders for misusing government resources on abandoned projects.
I'm going to make a follow-up. Because to me, it seems the contractor was supposed to do 4 projects. But the 2 projects were done. The 2 projects were abandoned. Why? We need an answer for that question. But not from here, from the ministry.
Kazo District is made up of 12 sub-counties with a population of 230,000 people. Out of 12 sub-counties, only 3 can access clean water.
My suggestion is, Honorable Minister and the senior national water manager of operations, that if we can have everything, where it needs boreholes, let them go there. Where it needs dams, let the dams be disseminated. Where there is a national water that can reach, let it be done. Because for sure, we've been lacking water for the rest of our lives.
Story by Timothy Mushabe for the news.